Anton Skoro with Fisticuff Radio and Pro MMA Now, standing next to a guy that I am so happy and so proud to call my friend, Marty B, baby. What's up?
What's up, brother? What's up? What do you want to know? I took a kick. I took that motherfucker down. Wait, can I cuss?
Yes.
I can cuss? All right. So anyways, what had happened was, you know what? I wasn't planning on catching a left. It caught me. I took it. I took him down. I got dominant position. I got the full mount. I was pounding him. I seen the blood. Amateurs, I know when you see blood, if they don't stop it, I knew I took a good one. So I was like, that's probably me bleeding. I thought it was my nose because, you know, I was dehydrated, so. Because I cut like 20 fucking pounds.
More than 20, buddy. You cut like 60 pounds, dude. I know Marty at 225, and Marty fought at 155. So, dude, I want to talk to you first and foremost about, obviously, you know, the weight cut. But I also want to talk to you about why you did this, because it's not like you're going to become a fighter. This isn't a new profession for you. No. This was kind of a... like, hey, let's go fishing in the ocean and take a fucking paddle boat. Like,
no, absolutely. I can tell you exactly how it happened. We were sitting around. We have really good fight parties. You know this. Everybody knows it. We have really good fight parties. And we were sitting around, and one of my fat friends was sitting on the couch with a piece of pizza and a beer, and he's like, release the wrist, release the wrist. I'm like, what do you mean release the wrist? You don't even know what he's talking about. He's like, I got this. Release the wrist. He'll get out of it. I'm like, you can't do this. And we're sitting on the couch. I'm like, what are you talking about? You're trying to coach this guy. Really? I was like, you get in there. He goes, you get in there. I was like, okay, let's do it. And I'm 60, 70 pounds overweight. I'm like, okay, I'll do it. Fuck it. Let's do it. So I came up with couch to cage. I was 70 pounds overweight. I was sitting there drinking, doing what Marty B does, hanging out, and I decided, you know what, I'm gonna get in the cage. I'm gonna do it. And you know what? I fucking did it. And it was awesome. So I'm telling you right now, anybody that wants to do it can do it. It's an amazing experience, and you get in phenomenal shape. You might get kicked in the head. But you know what? When you step on the stage, it's your fucking world, man.
Dude, I love it, Marty. And I want to ask this too, bro, because, I mean, obviously this is a new experience for you, and this is something that you'll take for the rest of your life.
Absolutely.
Like, out of this experience, what do you think was the most that you learned about yourself, and what's the thing that you're going to take with you out of this? Other than you would have licked the nuts of a camel for some water.
Well, first of all, it ain't chemo, but I'm telling you, this was the hardest thing I've ever done in my life. The hardest thing I've ever done in my entire life. But I did it, and it was worth it. But anybody can do it. Everybody comes up and they're like, Marty, how did you do it? How did you cut weight? How did you? And I was, you know, I was chubby. I was a little pudgy. I had a little jelly roll going on. And then I came in ripped, you know, and I went from 225 to 160. And they go, how do you do it? And I was like, diet, motherfucker, and exercise. I'm just saying, it's not a secret. There's not a pill, people. There's not a pill. It's diet and exercise. Chicken breast, egg whites, and run. That's it.
All right, Marty. So obviously, like I said, this isn't going to be a new career for you. Any chance that you'll try this again?
It's not going to be a new career for me. I'm the president of Home Me Clothing, and I did this as a bucket list. Like, when I go bungee jumping, I'm going to do it once. I went skydiving. I did that shit once. Negative. Got my nipple pierced. I did it once. I didn't do the other one because it hurt so bad. Fuck that. It's a bucket list thing, bro. I'm done. It's cool. I'm done. You'll never see me this small again. I'm getting ready to get beast mode. Get more. What? What?
Hey, I was going to talk about that too, man, because I'm not used to seeing you at 155. Usually you make me feel small, but tonight I'm kind of feeling like the big guy. I just wanted to know, brother, how does it feel to weigh as much as some women?
That hurt my feelings. No comment.
All right, Marty. So before I let you go, brother.
This is a good shot for the camera.
This is a great, great shot. So, dude, before I let you go, anybody you want to give a shout out to, thank?
Absolutely. Absolutely. First and foremost, It Ain't Chemo. They do the best things in the world for anybody in the United States of America. I can't say what they do. They do phenomenal things for so many people. Second, I want to thank Extreme Couture. They're awesome. They whipped my ass into shape. Everybody else, you know who you are. Friends, family, love you. Peace out. You guys know who you are.
All right, dude, and before we go, Mark, come up a little bit closer because I want everybody in the internet world to get a close look at this shit because I promise you, this thing is ugly.
You mean to spread it open a little bit?
Yeah. Hey, all I got to say is you might need to be 18 to watch this video, but it's cool. You could be 12, and this is what happens when you get in the cage and fight. Trust and believe.
Couch to cage, baby. Couch to cage.
All right, guys. So big shout out to Humble Me Clothing. Big shout out to It Ain't Chemo, Extreme Couture, Beneath the Surface Tattoo, and of course, the Gun Store. No need to shout out us. Shout out my boy at Humble Me Clothing, Marty B, baby. This is Anton Skoro with Fisticuff Radio and Pro MMA Now. Hella proud of this guy and hella happy to call this dude my friend. True Warrior right here. We're out.